ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। So we are memorizing verses from Bhagavad Gita. Today is 28th day. We'll be doing a verse from chapter 4, verse number 2. We did verse number 1 last time. So in continuation of that verse, we'll do second verse today. Again, a very important verse of Bhagavad Gita and has a lot of teachings for each one of us. So just give me a minute. I'm trying to share the screen. It's from chapter 4, verse number 2. Sometimes the system gets stuck. Okay, I hope you are able to see the screen now. Oh, the screen not visible yet. I'm so sorry. Sometimes such problems happen, technical issues. So, verse number 2 from chapter 4. Let's introduce ourselves to the verse, or the verse to ourselves, every single word of the verse. Evam parampara praptam इमं राजर्षयो विदुः स कालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तप। एवं परंपरा प्राप्तम् इमं राजर्षयो विदुः स कालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तप। Very simple verse actually. Let's look at the meaning now. This supreme science, the science of yoga, was thus received through the chain of disciplic succession, parampara. And the saintly kings, the Raja Rishis, understood it in that way. But in course of time, Sir Kalineha, the succession was broken, yoga nashtaha, and therefore the science as it is appears to be lost. Practice. Evam parampara praptam. Evam parampara praptam. Evam parampara praptam. Imam Raja Shayo Viduhu. Imam Raja Shayo Viduhu. Imam Raja Shayo Viduhu. Sakalineha Mahata. Sakalineha Mahata. Sakalineha Mahata. Yogo nashtaha parantapa, yogo nashtaha parantapa, yogo nashtaha parantapa. Evam parampara praptam imam raja shayo vituhu. Evam parampara praptam imam raja shayo vituhu. Evam parampara praptam imam raja shayo vituhu. Sakalini hamahata योगो नष्टः परन्तपः सकालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तपः सकालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तपः एवं परंपरा प्राप्तं इमं राजर्षयो विदुः सकालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तपः एवं परंपरा प्राप्तं इमं राजर्षयो विदुः सकालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तपः एवं परंपरा प्राप्तं इमं राजर्षयो विदुः सकालिनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तपः. Let's look at the meaning of each word. Evam means thus. Parampara, by disciplic succession. Praptam, received. So the knowledge, this knowledge, is thus received in disciplic succession. Imam, now this word came in the previous verse also. Imam vivasvate yogam. And also it has come many times before. So can anyone try guessing what's the meaning of this word imam? It's a simple, very simple meaning. Any guess? No? Okay. This word means this. Imam means this. Okay. This science, this knowledge. So this, it actually means this, and then depending on the context, it will become this science or this knowledge or this thing or that, this object, whatever it may be. Raja Rishayo. Raja Rishayo means the saintly kings. Raja means king, Rishi means saint. So Raja Rishayo means those who are saintly and also kings. Vidu, understood. So the saintly kings, this receive this knowledge in parampara and disciplic succession, and that's how they understood it. Sa Kali Neha Mahata. Sa, again, sa refers to that knowledge. Kalineha, in the course of time, in this world, mahata, this great knowledge, yogo, yoga, this word came in the previous verse also, imam vivasvate yogam. So yoga refers here to the science of knowledge of the relationship of Supreme Lord and the living entity. So yogo, nashtaha, nashtaha, the word nashtaha has one meaning called destroyed, isn't it? But actually, the word nashta can also have some more similar meanings. Here, the meaning taken is scattered, means something which is not at place, you know, something which has fallen out of the correct place, lost, or here and there, scattered around, not at one place, in whole piece. Parantapa, O Arjuna. Subduer of the enemies. This is one of the names of Arjuna, Parantapa, one who chastises one's enemies. So the meaning is very simple. Let's do this exercise now. The fun part. Try to identify the missing words. Yes, indeed, the communication, Mataji.
Evam parampara praptam.
Evam parampara praptam. Imam dash viduho. Ashokji.
Raj rishyo. Imam raj rishyo viduho.
Very good. Imam raj rishyo viduho. No, it should be viduho. In Sanskrit, of course, this is something technical. Whenever we see an H with a dot, that H with a dot is called anuswara. And the sound that is going to be made after that anuswara should be the sound of the vowel before that anuswara. So here you see, before H with a dot, there is a vowel, U. We pronounce it as, this word, we pronounce it as vidu. So now that U sound should also follow the anuswara. So it should become viduhu. Okay. Now, this is just a basic detail about it. It needs 10, 15, 20 minutes just to understand how this H dot has to be pronounced differently in different words, in different situations, means in the way they come in the verse. So that's one little technical info. And it should be vidu, not vidu ho, vidu. Third line, sa dash mahata. Who will try this? Govind Mahaprabhu.
Sa kale neha mahata.
Very good. Sa kale neha mahata. Last line, please someone try. Yogo dash dash. Yes, Geeta Gamya Mataji.
Yogo nashtaha parantapa.
Very good. Yogo nashtaha parantapa. The knowledge got lost, you know. Okay, next one. Next exercise. Evam dash praptam. It's received in this particular thing. What is that called? Ashokji.
Oh, parampara. Disciple succession. Evam parampara.
Evam parampara praptam dash rajashayo dash Geeta Gamyamataji.
Evam parampara praptam imam rajarshayo viduho.
Imam rajarshayo
viduho. Imam rajarshayo viduho. Viduho.
Sa kalineha. Dash sa kalineha. What's the missing word? Someone else would like to try. Sa kalineha. Yes, Govind Mahaprabhu.
So kale neha mahata.
Also, the next last line also please complete.
Yogo nashta parantapa.
Very good. Now, those of you who have memorized this verse and want to try the second day tables, please go ahead. Yes, Geeta Gamya Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Evam parampara praptam imam rajarshayo vidu. Sakale neha mahata yogo nashtaha parantapa.
Very good. Nigita Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Evam parampara praptam imam rajarshayo vidho sakale neha mahata yogo nashtaha.
Very nice. Thank you. Ashokji.
Evam parampara praptam imam rajarshayo vidho sakalen eha mahata yogo nashto parantapa.
Thank you. Okay. All right. So it's a very simple verse and with little practice you can easily memorize it. Now this has a very important teaching. Parampara word has come here. So we understand that it's parampara that maintains the knowledge, that protects, preserves the knowledge, and then also passes it on to others. When it's mentioned here that the knowledge got lost, actually in the previous verse, Lord Krishna said that he gave this knowledge first to Sun God. Then Sun God gave it to his son Manu. Manu gave it to son Ikshvaku Maharaj. After that, Krishna did not take any more names. Then he said, you know, this, he gave an example and he said, this is how the knowledge came down from one person to another person, from the father to the son, from the guru to the disciple. But this chain which I'm talking about is not an ordinary chain. It's a chain of very special people. They are saintly kings, great kings, not ordinary kings. These kings are like saints. They have many, many wonderful qualities of a saint. Examples, few examples can be of Maharaj Yudhishthir, Maharaj Prithu, those who really knew Dharma very well and they followed Dharma very well. They were actually qualified to be Brahmanas, but somehow that they were kings. By their qualities, they were almost like Brahmanas. So such personalities, they passed on the knowledge like this, but in due course of time, and now that's tragedy, that's unfortunate, that the knowledge got lost. The knowledge doesn't get destroyed because it's eternal knowledge. In the verse previous to this, only Krishna has said, this is avyaya jnana. It cannot be destroyed, it's eternal. So the knowledge got lost. And how did the knowledge disappear? Why it disappeared? Now that's something very important for us to understand. There are two aspects of receiving any knowledge. One thing is, we receive it theoretically. We get the knowledge as an information. We memorize it. We understand it. But the knowledge becomes complete only and only when that theory is translated in our life as practice. When we personally apply that knowledge, and then that knowledge becomes a part of our life, so much so that we become that knowledge, we become a living example of that knowledge, then actually we have received complete knowledge. Only theoretically knowing it means we know it little bit, somewhat. But when we realize it, then we know it fully, then we own that knowledge. That knowledge is ours, and that knowledge is not different from us. Then because we become a living example of that knowledge, we can teach that knowledge to others in a very nice way, complete way, and that other person can also completely receive it. So when this practice at individual level stops, that's how the knowledge also starts becoming lost. Because then there's no one who is living that knowledge, no one is practicing that knowledge. So in that chain of disciplic succession, it might have happened. Now, when it happened, that Krishna didn't mention, but it might have happened that some personalities, they stopped living as per that knowledge, and that's why they were not able to also 100% pass it on to others in a very pure way, complete way, and the knowledge got lost. So parampara has a very special role to play. It protects the knowledge from outside attack, doesn't allow others to destroy that knowledge, either physically destroying the books or actually destroying the concepts or the purity of the knowledge, the siddhanta, the principles. Then it also preserves the knowledge, means there is an external threat to it and there is an internal threat. What is the internal threat? I have the knowledge, but I'm not practicing it in my personal life. So it preserves. And then the third thing which it does, it passes it on to others. It shares. Why? Because if they don't share, then the parampara, the succession will be broken, the chain will be broken. Like I was explaining sometime before, in the past we have seen great kings, they always had one concern, one worry. If they die without giving birth to a qualified son who can take over the kingdom after they leave, it's going to be a great disaster for the kingdom. So even Maharaj Dashrath, he was worried, I don't have someone to rule over after me, rule over the kingdom after me. I don't have an heir. There's no one to sit on the throne after me. And he was so worried that this is something very important for me. Then, of course, after long period of wait, Sri Ramchandra, he took birth in that family, appeared in that family. So just like great kings would have this concern that I need someone qualified to take the responsibility of the throne, royal throne. Likewise, the great teachers, they have a concern. Whom should I give this knowledge? A qualified person who will receive this knowledge, practice it properly, and then pass it on to others. And this way the parampara, the flow of knowledge will be maintained. So this is something how parampara has a role to play for this protection of this knowledge. And individually also we have a big lesson to learn from this verse. If we have some or other come in contact with a parampara, bona fide parampara, and we are getting the benefit of receiving this transcendental knowledge, wonderful knowledge from that parampara, it with that gift which you are receiving from the parampara comes a responsibility. And what is that responsibility? It's not something which is optional. It is not something that if I like, I'm going to do it. Or, you know, I have to really, really become very qualified and then only I can start doing it. Or I give the excuse, I'm not qualified, so I cannot do it. No. As soon as we receive this knowledge, the onus of the responsibility of sharing this knowledge with others comes upon us. Now that sharing of knowledge should be done because it's a matter of duty. We have received the gift. Now we are indebted to the parampara. So now we should be distributing it to others. Doesn't matter to how many people we are able to distribute. Doesn't matter to what extent we are able to distribute. But whatever we have sincerely received, we are sincerely trying to follow and we are getting benefited from, we should try to pass it on to others. That will be our then dutiful contribution towards the parampara. And that comes as responsibility. It's not that whether I want to do it or not, or I'm not qualified, then the parampara expects us to become qualified. Just like if the son of a king is not able enough, the king expects that you, my dear son, should become qualified. Likewise, the parampara expects us to become qualified. And in whatever way, small way or big way, we should pass it on to others in a very humble mode out of duty. Not that I am a great teacher, I am a great compassionate person, I have so much of concern for other people, they are suffering and I want to help them. Okay, such feelings are very good. But before all those feelings and concerns and ideas about one's own qualification, we should consider this principle. It's my duty. I should be doing it for the sake of protecting this knowledge. So this is an important lesson for each one of us that yes, as soon as we get connected to parampara, whatever we learn, sincerely practice it, get benefited from, we must share it with others as a matter of duty without becoming falsely proud. That because I have received it, I should be given it. Then the knowledge will always remain alive in the lives of others as well as our own personal life. Evang parampara praptam imam rajashriyo vituhu sakaline hamanta. Yogo nashtaha parantapa. This supreme science was thus received through the chain of disciplic succession, and the saintly kings understood it in that way. But in course of time, the succession was broken, and therefore the science as it is appears to be lost. We'll end here. Thank you so very much for joining in. I appreciate that you take out time to join. See you again on Wednesday. Next verse, 4.3, will be discussed in that class. Thank you very much.